Denko and Swetensky of the Soviet Union, Natalia and Genrich, fourth overall, the only ones with a chance to overtake Wilson and McCall. And as Dick indicated, that's tough to do in figure skating unless the ones you're trying to overtake really bombed. And as you saw, Wilson and McCall did not.
Well, you know, the Soviets have had such an incredible impact on ice dancing, sort of like a repeat of the 1909 Ballet Russe appearances in Paris, when all the world turned to Soviet dancing. Stroking and edging.
Championships and fourth, unless they pull up tonight.
It's called waiting your turn.
Yeah. Of the Soviet Union.
And the ending of that program, you know, was really almost non-stop. There was very little build-up or high on it, and I think it kind of cut down the quality of this dance.
All right, we'll be back after this word from our local stations.
of the 15th Olympic Winter Games as ABC's coverage from Calgary continues. Once again, here's Jim McKay.
And here's the first set of marks for Aronenko and Stripinski. 5-5 to 5-7. It looks like they might be resigned to fourth place again. Let's see the next set of marks, however. And then we will know. Waiting their turn, as Dick said, to ascend in the Soviet ice dancing hierarchy. 5-5 to 5-8. 5-8 from the Austrian judge. And where does that put them? It puts them in fourth place. A wide look at the Saddle Dome, and the people still waiting for the award ceremony. So here are the final standings in ice dancing. The gold medal, the Bestemyanova and Bukin of the Soviet Union, Klimova and Ponomarenko, the Soviet second, Wilson and McCall of Canada, third. Sixth place for Susie Semenik and Scott Gregory, who skated very well tonight, and 11th place for Susan Wynn and Joseph Drouart.